fetch it for you.
Can't believe I dreamt about that horrible memory again. It's been 8 years already and I still can't forget about it. Right now, I'm studying at an orphanage. Pretty lame. My life sucks. I'm hated by everyone since... I don't know. I hate myself. Tragedy? No happy ending, huh? Sounds a lot like me. Who was this guy again? Edgar Allan Poe. Interesting. Footsteps are heard and a black silhouette walks towards the grave of Edgar Allan Poe. The figure kneels in front of his grave and sets the cognac and roses down.
Pa, is Ma okay?
She's okay, son. She's just...
It's a boy!
What does she mean, Pa?
She means you're going to have a baby brother on the way. Do you want to see him, Henry?
This way, sir, to your wife. David, my love. Henry, won't you come here?
Ma, Pa, what are you going to call him?
Edgar.
We're going to name him Edgar Poe.
Father abandons their family. He left Elizabeth with Henry and a 2-year-old Edgar.
Pa! Papa!
Pa! Don't leave us! Mama! She needs you! She's pregnant right now!
Don't touch me, you useless boy! We don't have enough money for a third child. and I'm not even sure if that's my child she's bearing. Oh, gods!
In David's absence, Elizabeth gave birth to Rosalie Poe, Edgar's younger sister. Elizabeth started showing signs of tuberculosis. Of her death, news reached the Poe family that David Poe, Edgar's father, died with the same disease. The kids split up, being adopted by different families. Rosalie was taken by the Mackenzie family of Richmond.
Brother, why are they taking her away?
They are her new family now, Edgar. And soon, you two will be taken away.
Why can't I stay with you, brother?
I'm going to live with our paternal grandparents, and they don't have the money to sustain the both of us. Sorry, Edgar.
Edgar, son, I'm John Allen.
And I'm Francis Valentina, your foster mom. Welcome to the family.
From now on, you're Edgar Allan Poe. Don't put us in shame.
Edgar, now 15 years old, got good education from his foster family. He was a good student.
Good, good son. Not a single mistake. Now, go back to your room and study. I'm expecting more coming from you.
Yes, Mother.
John, give Edgar a break.
Francis, fun is for babies. Edgar is no longer like that. And now he should pay for every penny I wasted on him. He should be grateful for the good education I provided for him.
Yes, sir.
Edgar walks inside the school library and catches sight of Sarah Elmira Royster. She was reading a book upon his entry.
Thank you.
but do I know you?
No, and I too don't know you. But Elijah, tell me your name, for you got me intrigued just by your presence.
I am Sarah Elmira Royce. Now, may I know your name?
I'm Edgar Allan Poe. Pleasure to meet you, Elijah.
And I to you, sir.
Days after their meeting, they continued to meet up and talk. Eventually, Edgar started courting the beautiful Elmira.
Tell you, Elmira.
What is it, Edgar?
Elijah, I confess with all my heart that I am in love with you. My soul yearns for your embrace every day. I want you to be my lover.
Standards.
I'll wait for you in the garden.
One step is enough, kid.
One step doesn't justify how mad I feel right now. She needs to wake up from her silly, stupid fantasy.
Elmira went to the garden, searching for her lover.
Edgar? Edgar? Edgar?
I'm here, milady.
Why have you brought me here, Edgar? I'm sorry for my parents.
It's okay.
So, what do you need me for? Edgar, you should know that my parents doesn't want you with me.
I just have to give you this. Milady, my love for thee isn't as sweet to be broken so easily by your parents. Goodbye, love.
A dream too bright to last, a starry hope that didst arise, but to be overcast, a voice from out the future cries, on, but o'er the past. Dim gulf, my spirit hovering lies, mute, motionless, aghast, for alas, alas me, for me the light of life is over. No more, no more, no more. Such language holds the solemn sea to the sands upon the shore. Shall bloom the thunder-blasted tree, or the stricken eagle soar?
Edgar is in his room, writing. His foster father suddenly went inside. Edgar turns to look at him.
Come in. Edgar, let's talk. What do you wish to talk to me, father?
I will get straight to the point. You are to study at the University of Virginia for higher education.
But father, what's wrong with education here?
There's nothing wrong. Plenty of distractions exist here. Like that girl we became close with. Who is she again? Sarah Elmira Royster? Oh, even your parents doesn't want you to court her.
I cannot transfer schools. I do not wish to do so.
You ungrateful Frank, I pray for education, your daily living, and this is how you pay me?
But father, you never let me enjoy my life. Never!
My decision is final, Edgar. And if you want, you will have one day. One day to be with your beloved Sarah in your life.
Yes, sir.
Next day, he rushes to the Elmira residence to bid farewell to his first love attachment.
Edgar, what are you doing here? Ma or Pa might see you.
I do not care whoever sees me. All that matters is I've got to see you. I won't be too long, lady. I came to bid you farewell. For I will be leaving to the University of Virginia to continue my studies. I promise to write letters. Like.
All right. I wish you all the best, my dear Edgar.
Have you read the letters I gave you in the garden, Lemira? Elmira, you know I love you, and that my love is true. So I ask you to wish nothing more than to love and be loved by me, Sarah Elmira Royster. Would you do me the honor of being engaged to me right at this moment?
I'd gladly be your fiancé, Edgar. I love you too. Edgar, I'll miss you.
I'll miss you too.
Sorry, but the library is about to close.
Oh, sorry. What time is it?
It's about night time already.
What?
Do you want to buy that book?
Yes.
John Allan sent his son to his new school.
Son, remember, this is for your own good. Do not fail us, make us proud.
Understood, father. Goodbye, father.
John Allan said nothing in response and waved at him as he started to walk away and enter the school called University of Virginia.
vulnerability. Learn to express a range of emotions such as fear and sadness.
Understanding language using combining forms. The combining form tele comes from the Greek and means far off. Since you were listening to my lecture, I assume that you know what our lesson is about. Stand up, Sir Allan Poe, and tell me what you have learned.
Classics and modern languages enable you to combine the study of Latin and or ancient Greek with the modern language. This course involves extensive study of major literary texts alongside training in linguistic skills. Is that the information you needed, Professor?
Very good response. Have you heard it, class?
Yes, Professor.
Good.
Edgar was talking to his foster father on the telephone.
Be grateful, you prank. The money I'm sending you should be enough.
No, father, it's not enough. The university has lately been acquiring more money from us to finally finish their construction. So please, father, I haven't eaten much lately due to my lack of money here.
Solve your own problems, Edgar. You're old enough,
but...
Is there something wrong, Edgar? You look horrible.
My father's not giving me enough penny to feed my stomach and my studies.
Is that so? So you know of the Charlottesville merchants? You could borrow some credit from them for now.
Edgar then asked for money from the Charlottesville merchants, but then busied himself the day of his debts. Seeing no more ways of getting more money, he started to gamble in hopes of getting more.
Edgar, don't give us the money.
Edgar, we have been playing for 2 hours already, and you haven't even won a single penny.
You're too unlucky with cards, Alan.
Edgar, what is this debt that I've been hearing about from your professors? Edgar the gambler? You bring shame to the Allan family, you prank.
This wouldn't have happened if you gave me more money, father.
Don't you dare put the blame on me, Edgar.
Please, father, help me pay my debts.
This problem is yours to handle. I have no part in it, so you solve it on your own, Edgar Poe. And from now on, you are prohibited to go back to the university. You put the Allan name in shame, Edgar.
For the love of God, father!
He left the university and returned to the Allan estate. As he entered his hometown, he was greeted by the sight of Sarah Elmira Royster, his first love. With another man, he approaches the two.
You see, my love.
Nice meeting you too, but I have somewhere to get to you.
Goodbye then.
Edgar went home to the Allan estate, where he felt unwelcomed by his foster father's anger. So, he decided to reside somewhere else and enter military to support his living.
I'm Edgar A. Perry, a 20-year-old clerk from Boston, and I'm here to join military service.
Come in.
Sir, I need to tell you something.
Sit down. What is it, Edgar?
The truth is, I'm not Edgar A. Perry. I'm just a 22-year-old Bostonian clerk. I'm not people thought I am. I came here to Boston to run away from the rejection I felt from my friends, family, and especially from my ex-fiancé in Richmond.
What happened? What made him reject you?
I have a plenty amount of shares in debt. I've experienced a gambling life, and I live life like heavens and fates are always against me. I am successful right now as part of the military services, but I am quite unhappy. That is why, Salle, I'm asking you to discharge me once and for all.
In one condition, reconcile with your father.
After plenty of attempts through letters, Edgar's foster father, John Allan, finally agreed to reconcile with him. Edgar found it weird, but soon knew the reason. He went home the day after his mother's burial.
Father. Son, I'm sorry. I should have reconciled with you sooner. And you could have met her during her last days.
Father, how dare you? No, how dare you talk to me like that? How could you? How could you, father, two illegitimate twins of a woman you have yet to marry and younger than me for 20 years? You have no right to interfere with my life. You! Get out of my house and out of my life. Consider this day, the day that you are no longer my son. As you wish, John Allan.
Edgar left the Allan estate and went to live together with his aunt, Maria Clem, his paternal grandmother, his older brother Henry, and his 13-year-old first cousin, Virginia. He knocked on the house where his biological relatives live in.
Coming. Edgar!
Brother!
What brings you here?
Long story.
Who do we have here? Edgar, what brings you to our home?
Long story. I got disowned by John Allan.
Poor soul. From here onwards, you're gonna sleep in this room. Grandma's actually sleeping right now. And my daughter. Speaking of my daughter, I have yet to introduce her to you. Virginia! Virginia!
Coming, Ma!
Virginia!
I'm already here!
Virginia, this is your cousin, Edgar. Edgar, this is my daughter, Virginia. I'll leave you two alone, find something to prepare to cook. Let's go, William.
Virginia, an honor to meet you.
The feeling's mutual, sir.
As time went by,
The two cousins grew closer. Their feelings for each other were kept hidden as a secret. Edgar went inside of Aunt Maria Clem's house finding his brother, Henry, drinking an excessive amount of alcohol. He tries to stop him but is unable to do so when his brother kept on staying stubborn. And during the process of Edgar stopping Henry from drinking, his brother passed out, lying on the floor.
Brother!
Dead.
What are you doing?
Edgar! Welcome back! We have a pretty weather up in our heads today, huh, mate?
Brother, you're drunk. Too much alcohol.
No! Don't take away my wine. My beloved wine. Oh, wine.
Brother! Henry!
When Edgar's brother died, this is where he started to become serious towards his writings. But having not much money, he is unable to publish his works. He begs for money from random people.
Help me, please. I lack of money and I am unable to be employed to any jobs. help me, please.
Forgive me, but I cannot.
Sorry for my late presence, Edgar. I brought someone along with me.
No, it's okay. Who did you bring along, sir?
A pleasure to meet you, sir.
White, I'm Thomas White. The pleasure is mine.
Sir Thomas White is the editor of the Southern Literary Messenger in Richmond. And we have discussed that your works will be published in his guidance. As repayment, you can work as his assistant editor.
I thank you, Sir John Kennedy. Thank you, Sir Thomas White. Thank you.
He worked as Thomas White's assistant editor. He finally had a job where he can earn money, until he was caught drunk by his boss. Edgar was in his office, provided by his job as his assistant editor when Thomas White entered.
Edgar! It's Fats White everywhere! Sir Thomas! What brings you here?
Edgar! I didn't give you this office to be a place to your drug addiction to wine! Depart from this office because you are fired!
Sir! No! Wine to me is literary device.
Stop with your reasons! Wine? Ha! Literary device? Ha! You're obviously drunk!
He returns to Baltimore, to his aunt and cousin. He shares to them the bad news and asks for their advice.
Thank you for having me back. Never expect me to do this again, Edgar. Understood, sir.
Erica, about Edgar. Tell us what you know of him.
Edgar Allan Poe?
Life for Edgar was going a bit more smoothly. He married Virginia again, this time in public. At first, people disagreed with their marriage, but Edgar smoothed them all out.
What do you mean, marry my daughter? She's too young and you're a bit too old for her.
Auntie, in love, age doesn't matter. And one more thing, I love her too much to let such a trivial thing ruin us. I promise to give her a good life, Aunt Maria Clem.
Take care of her, Edgar.
Yes, we don't need to hide the secret. I love you, Virginia.
And my love too. I want to stay like this forever.
Yes, forever.
But we all know forever does not exist. She fell on the floor and kept complaining her back hurt. Edgar, who was a bit drunk and was writing a story, rushed to her side.
Virginia! Please, no! Not you too! Don't let me lose you!
I'm fine! Don't worry, my love!
No, you're not fine at all!
Edgar, always and forever.
If you love me always and forever, why did you leave me alone, Virginia?
Surrounding their house were critics and biographers, totally interested in the death of another beautiful woman in Edgar's life. He locked himself in his room, drinking heavily.
Edgar Allan Poe, can we talk to you? Edgar!
Noisy, annoying critics! Damn them! So what if the freaking theme of my story is always the death of a woman? Is it my fault that every woman I love in my life either died or separated from me? I didn't wish my life to be like this. Virginia, what do I do without you? I thought you'd last forever, but you left me behind. I can't live like this, living without someone to love and be loved by me.
Edgar goes to court Sarah Whitman, a poet he has been interested on.
Someone out there!
My wife, Virginia, died. Do you love me? Please say yes. Let me love you. I can't live like this.
No, Edgar, you're drunk. Tell me what you're saying.
I perfectly know what I'm saying. Marry me, Sarah. Be my wife.
No, Edgar. What is this proposal I'm hearing about? Edgar, you're drunk. Get away from my daughter.
Seeing no other women, he drank heavily until he heard of the news of the widowed Elmira. He went back to his first love. He knocked on the door of the Sheltons.
Elmira! Elmira! Elmira!
Edgar? What are you doing here?
Elmira! Whom I missed? Why? Why? Why did you go off with another man while I was gone? Why, milady?
You promised you'd write to me, Edgar. Not the letter arrived.
Every day, every night, Elmira, I wrote a letter to you, thinking of you all the time. Not one day I forgot to send you a letter, and not once I have received a reply from you.
But my father.
I love my Annabelle.
My father won't let me. My family won't let me. My children refuse to let me. I can't, Edgar. I'm sorry.
Edgar drank heavily that night. He was roaming around the streets of Baltimore,
stumbling around and bumping himself from wall to wall. A man named Joseph W. Walker saw him.
Hello, help please. A man I found in Baltimore streets is in need of your attention. Please hurry.
Footsteps are heard and a black silhouette walks towards the grave of Edgar Allan Poe. The figure kneels in front of his grave and sets the cognac and roses down.
He was once my son, but now a stranger.
Adopted he may be, but still I am his mother.
Me, his sister? I never knew him as a brother.
Pity I have for my family. I wish we grow to be closer.
I know when Edgar was a horrible, ungrateful man.
He was a son I had grown to love, my dear John Allan.
He loved my daughter Almira with his whole heart.
Yet I just can't let it be, so I broke them apart.
He is the guy whom I love so desire.
Yes, he is the guy whose heart never gets tired.
My poor Edgar lost too many loved ones. Never will I care how he laughs or the comedy.
Intoxicated, a drunken fool, he told me he loved me.
I and him against the whole world, yet still he says he loves me.
I, who died, love Edgar. I just hope he'll still say he loves me.
For it is my wish, my only reason of living, to love and be loved by him.
He was hated. He was loved. He was pitied and ignored. He lives a life full of tragedy, and he died with no happy ending.
Lord, help my poor soul.
Hey, what are you doing here?
I'm just returning a book. You see, I'm kind of interested in Edgar Allan Poe.
You are... cool.
I think reading old books is cool. That's a great thing to know that I'm not the only one thinking that way.
I guess we're kind of people that prefer reading books than socializing with others. I just read about Edgar Allan Poe last week, and I'm willing to read more books.
What about William Shakespeare?